It's a real pleasure to be here today for a conference that's focused on ways to build trust and truth in health research. Good health and healthcare depend on people making well-informed decisions. A part of this is giving people reliable information from a source they can trust. Over the past two decades, government investment and commitment to research has led to significant improvements in Ireland's health research system. Our plan for living with COVID-19 acknowledges the crucial role of research and innovation to inform and shape our public health and policy responses. COVID-19 has shown us all the critical role research plays in providing reliable information to inform policy. We're a small country, but our research contribution has been significant. Researchers here are leading and contributing to clinical trials and a wide range of other research and evidence to inform decision making. Along with the pandemic, we've seen an infodemic. There's been an overload of information, a lot of which has been unreliable. We've seen examples of this in relation to the use of vaccines and on unproven medicines and treatments. This has exposed people and populations to the risk of using health interventions that are harmful or not using those known to be of benefit. So this conference comes at a crucial point in terms of dispelling myths and ensuring people know how to discern fact from fiction. I congratulate the Health Research Board and their partners, Evidence Synthesis Ireland, the HRB Trial Methodology Research Network, and Cochrane Ireland for bringing together more than 700 people over 2 days. The conference will raise awareness and understanding of misinformation and disinformation and its consequences. It will explore the solutions available to everyone for assessing the credibility of any health claim and to become aware of trusted sources. And finally, it will delve into the responsibilities on everyone to ensure integrity in reporting and sharing health claims. Involving public and patients as contributors and as decision makers is central to the success of ensuring information is clear, reliable, and understood. It's refreshing to see that we had their involvement in both the development of this program and also within the program itself. I'd like to thank Deirdre McLaughlin and Anne Daly for their invaluable contributions. We need informed decision makers and we need an informed public. To ensure people are informed, we must ensure we invest in research to generate reliable evidence and educate people so they know how to distinguish fact from fiction and challenge myths when they arise. I see this conference as a stepping stone in our journey to achieving this. I know the Health Research Board and its partners will continue to lead in the generation and promotion of understanding of reliable information in the healthcare sector. Thank you so much for all your work.